So we start the talk. Who has question? Who want to ask? Can answer.
Samdarshi, when I was younger, I used to love Gurdjieff a lot. Gurdjieff, the master, Gurdjieff.
Gurdjieff.
Yes. And reading his book, I mean, it's clearly he was really a rascal and a cheater as well. I mean, he was painting birds and selling his other things, and he cheated a lot. And I never understand exactly what is this karma that everybody's talking about. For example, I've cheated the bank insurances, but in my opinion, I mean, it's not that every action corresponds to a reaction. I mean, these are legal tips, so I had the opportunity to do it and I did it. But I don't think this will create my karma. Can you clear this point?
What you say, he is more like a cheater?
Yeah, cheated bank, yes, and insurances.
He?
Me.
Ah,
yes.
And what about Gurdjieff?
No, Gurdjieff also was a cheater. I mean, he was selling birds and he did a lot of things.
Birds?
Birds, yeah, he was painting birds and selling as a rare species, you know. He did many things and he was real. Of course, he isn't like.
No, but if he is painting birds and sailing, then what means cheating?
Yeah, cheating people because when they go home, after a while, the birds lose the color. And they bought it as, for example, I don't know, parrots. Okay, parrots. And then they become sparrows. That is cheating. But I mean, also he used to repair many things, and for example, a lady went to him because with a sewing machine, and she was despaired because it was not working. So he told her, please come back the day after, okay, and the sewing machine will be ready. And it was only that the lady didn't know that there was a switch to make it, and he was getting money because He also maintained his disciple as well, you know, I mean, he was giving food and this, because in those years, Russia had a really big problem, you know, the revolution and everything. No, but what I would like to know is, what is this karma? I mean, if one, like a bank or insurance, is a thief, is a legal thief, but is a thief. If someone cheats the thief, what is this karma?
They can understand.
Not
clear. No.
Cheating.
Yes, about cheating. You know what is cheating.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. But I mean, Gurdjieff was a master, and he used to do it.
Вопрос был такой. Гурдджиев говорил, что вот он рисовал какие-то картинки, да, птицы, а потом вот эти птицы исчезали. А у него был такой опыт, что он обманывал страховые компании, банки и какие-то это. Создается ли при этом карма?
Yes, good, thank you.
I'm here.
Good, very short and good.
Maybe in his side is no cheating, because they cannot cheat. But in normal man, if you have debt, you took from bank, from insurance, you have debt. Many people have mostly, they taking. And sometimes they pay and sometimes they cannot pay, can't pay back, bankrupt. But If legally you are check, they have to pay. Otherwise bank make case on them, make police on them, take them, even they can put in jail. Many people going like this. So this is worldly, material world, if you look, it is right. If you are doing anything, you promise, I take, I give back, and you have to give back. If you not give back, they will make some problem, some fine, some punishment. So it is normal thing in world, it is happening. But about Gurdjieff, even you say this story, but still I am not understood.
Okay.
What's happened?
Okay, I told you. I mean, he did many things, but okay, for example, just among the many that he did, because he was also trading with carpets and this and that and that.
Carpet,
yes. I mean, I just gave you examples. And I never did it with private people. I never cheated a person. I cheated corporation, bank, and this and that and that. But to survive, because he needed money, he did many things, and among these things, okay, he was also to do some cheating, you know, because painting parrots, he was without money. He was like that, he saw parrots, and he saw a sparrow, okay, and with a net, no? He had the idea, I will catch it, I will paint, and I will sell it for something else, not sparrow, okay? And he did it. But after a few days, he had to leave the village because, I mean, people were going back because they lost the color, you know? So, it's just an example among the things. For example, the sewing machine, okay? You are honest, you say to the lady, just this switch. Now he said, okay, leave it here one day and I will repair. And when the lady came back, he wanted money, but he was just a switch. So, I mean, is this cheating or not?
What, where from you heard this? Read?
Oh, yes. Yeah, there is a famous book on his life.
His book?
His book. Meeting with... remember the title? Meeting with Remarkable Man. Remarkable Man. He just say about all the people that he met on his way before, also before becoming a writer. And then he had as a disciple Uspensky, who helped him to write down in a proper way because he was not cultured, not learned, Gurdjieff was not learned. And Uspensky was a mathematician, a philosopher, and this and that. So on this book, I mean, you can read all these things. He was a rascal, beautiful rascal.
And this is his book. He wrote.
Yes.
He wrote and he said, I did this thing,
yes.
I doing this.
Yes.
But it is not cheating then. He said, okay, I make anything, painting.
Yeah.
He wrote also there, I'm saying.
Yeah, but he wrote it years and years later. I mean, people have been cheated.
That time he was already, when he doing this thing,
he was on his way. Okay, he was on his way, but I mean, he...
In enlightenment or not?
I think he was on his way.
On journey.
Yeah, on the journey, yes. But I mean, he was traveling in a lot, and he, of course, he didn't have money. He was very, very creative, you know? And also a very, very good salesman. So, I mean, he did it a lot.
Yeah, then in case anything, even enlightened or not enlightened, before enlightened, if anybody doing this type things, making karma sure happen. Maybe he creating karma with pupils. And then maybe after enlightenment, before enlightenment, sure, you doing many wrong karma. Everybody doing. Everybody unconscious, everybody unaware, and whatever they do, it is bad karma also happened, good karma also happened, and making bad karma also. And they have to pay back. So all master, this is not, after enlightenment is different. Even they're not making any karma. No any new karma, no any sanskara they're making. Even happening, because if anybody doing anything for that master, karma is created. Even you give one chai, make one chai for master, for Buddha, and karma is created. Even karma is created with everybody. You do anything to anyone, karma is created. He is like a death. You gave any one chai, karma is created, and he has to pay back later. And which way he pay back, this is different. And normal people paying back in normal way. Like karma, this is karma, science, mathematics. You have to take back, you have to give back. You have to took something, you have to pay back something. No anybody is free here, no one. And we have karma from our family, our relations, brother, sister, mother, father, everyone. Karma has. And has a whole, everybody is paying back. Only this work is happening here. We came here to paying back our karma from this life and from past lives, many lives. We pay. So this happening to everyone. But after awakening, and anybody awakened, then he also, somebody doing, sure somebody has to do for him something, some service, some work, some taking care, karma is creating. And when karma is creating, that moment, his energy, because his energy is overflow, too much. He full with himself and to overflow much. So that energy automatic, his love automatic going, and this love and light clean the karma. Even he not doing anything. He even not meeting this person. Somebody did anything, maybe he never meet again. But karma is created. And when karma is created, automatic it happened in aura. This happening already in enlightenment anyhow, but before enlightenment also. When you're doing meditation, as your space going bigger, energy going bigger, and your karma is cleaning by energy, by space. Often I say, many times I said, you doing meditation here. You doing meditation for you, it is not only for you. First thing, you heal yourself. First thing, you clean your darkness. And as your aura is become bigger, then automatic wherever your darkness is stuck. With whom? Sure, with family stuck. With family we have karma. With many other people has karma in world. And we don't know how many people we have, but we don't know. From past, even we didn't met them, but we have karma. And this karma is cleaning automatic by space. As your space become bigger, and then its cleaning happen. So, this is the right way to clean the karma. One way, clean the karma, like suppose you have karma with parents. Sure has. Parents gave you body. Parents make you big. Giving study, food and everything, taking care your many years. Sure, there you have to give back. So, outer people in outside saying, or some master also saying, you should have to pay back to karma with parents, with anyone with whom you have, do service them. They took your take care, now you take care them, when their time coming. When they are old, they cannot do anything, then you have to give back. And then it will be balanced, will be okay. You will be free from them. So one way is this. But this way is, here you cleaning karma, and by unconscious, if you living unconscious, you creating new karma. Every moment clean and create, clean and create. So never end happens. It is never come, it is time, okay, finish it. So whole world going like this. Everyone in this karma, game of karma. So right way of meditation. When you sitting in meditation, and karma, your karma, whatever karma you create, this karma is going, energy going in you as a darkness. And when you looking inside, looking your darkness, you close eyes, look the darkness. First thing you face your darkness. And this darkness, when as you facing, this darkness transforming in light. So with whom you have karma, they automatic it is clear. Clearance happens. You doing meditation here, for you is very good. Something happening for body good, for emotion good, for thoughts good, for mind good. But with whom you have karma inside, they also get. Even they sitting thousands meal. You are sitting here and they sitting in Moscow. Somebody sitting, your husband sit there, wife sit there, or anyone sit there. And with whom you have karma, they also get this energy. Sometimes they become, when too much energy going in them are happening, they become negative also. Their ego is hurting. Why, what is happening this? They become emotional very much. And sometimes they very much love feeling also. Because first thing, emotion has to come out there. And then there will be clear. Therefore, if anyone, one person becomes sannyasi in family, one man or one girl becomes sannyasi, slowly, slowly opportunity has, whole family become sannyasi. Whole family is feeling something start. And after some time, other one takes sannyas, then other one come. Even first, they fight. Ego is fighting. But slowly, slowly, because this vibration, this energy is working. Anyone doing meditation in home, this energy working in everyone. This is not. Depend on how much other person is sensitive. Who can take how much? Somebody very sensitive, very much take. Somebody very rock, cannot feel anything. Not feeling anything. But somehow something is this energy, this vibration is working. When you do meditation, your vibration is loving, more beautiful, more joyful, and then this energy is going spread. Everybody spread own energy, own vibrations. If your energy very dark, you throw darkness. You throw sadness. You throw violence. You throw, and if you are sensitive, if anyone come to you, and if he very full of violence, full of anger, and you are sensitive, you can feel it. Just he come and sit near you, and you feel it. Something happening start. Suddenly you are very good, you are okay. Somebody came and you boiling start. You becoming anger without reason. Anger start. And somebody coming with very loving energy, you feel very good, very more beautiful with you. You want to be with this person more, want to hug him, want to talk with him, sit near, take hand in hand, hugging, like want to be with him, because depend on your sensitivity. If you sensitive, you can feel. Everybody has own vibrations, and everybody throwing vibration from body, aura, from aura energy is going out. And this karma is cleaning with as your first aura become okay, aura become light, and then this light automatic clean your karma. And as your clean your karma with your relatives or friends or parents or family, you are here, even you meet them or not meet them, but you feeling love start with them. they feeling love with you, start with you. Because they are something is going out. Something is your, their darkness also going out. So everybody, we have darkness, taking darkness from each other. Everyone, this is unconscious game. Just you do anything with unconsciously for anyone, darkness coming in you, your darkness going there. But if you look to pupil, when they looking, sitting and talking with each other, just look what they talking. They just putting their heaviness. They are loaded too much and they say, okay, put. If anybody listening him very silently, very good, then you feel, very relaxed, very good. But if he also is full, you also full, he also full. Nobody listen to each other. And they just talking. No one is listening. Because he also full of heaviness. He also full of heaviness. And they're not listening at each other. And then not happen. But if one is silent, or more quiet and listen, just you go to psychologist. Many people now going in psychologist. Psychology doctor. What doctor doing this? Nothing doing. He very patient. 1 hour, 2 hours, whatever. Just listening. Okay. Listen. Say your story. You are, I am this. And he just... And this doctor is very patient. And after 1 hour, 2 hours, patient feels, something release. And he... not just yesterday was one Indian, 2 days before Indian. He had this doctor, psychologist. And I asked him, how you do, what you doing? He said, I'm not listening anything. I will be crazy. Only, but we have, like wife and husband, we have very much patience. And whole city only, he was the one doctor. And he said, this is patience I get from meditation. To be patient, be centered, and just I listening them. And no any medicine, no any machinery, no anything. Just one simple room, chairs there, table there. One he's sitting there, I'm sitting here. And he just, patient is talking. 2 hours, 1 hour, 3 hours sometime. And I'm listening. And listening with, and then they feel something is released. Because this doctor is not throw anything, not putting him anything. And he say, okay, release. But also, if you listening, then you will be heavy. This is art of listening. To listen, but don't listen. Then is right. In beginning, some Westerns came to my town. One woman was, her name was Dhyana, old woman. That time she was 60 around, now maybe 80. So we do satsang, silent sitting 1 hour, 1.5 hour. And just silence finish, I say, Om, finish, little music. And then just music start, and after 1-2, she start to talk. And she talking only one subject, her son. Son, only one son she has, and talking about her son and her house. She living in one island in Europe, Gomera. She just talking about these two things. And there was maybe 8 pupil, 9 pupil, 10 pupil maybe. And I'm listening, I just sit here and yes. One person get up, go in kitchen. Second get up, go in kitchen. Slowly, me and she. Nobody else. And 2 hours, every day almost happened this. She just talk. And I'm just silent, sit, listening, and slowly they everybody go. They're just doing their own thing, sometime going to drink chai, or do this, or do that. Then somebody asks, how you can, you are not tired? With me, ask. You are not tired, you are not bored, same story every day, same things. No any new also, no any new things. I say, I never listen. I'm not listening, otherwise sure I will be tired. Sure I will be heavy. I am not listening. But he says, you look like you are listening very much. You say, yes, yes, okay. And even you say to them, we are bored, we are angry also. Why is she talking all the time? I say, but she is full with this whole life. And she is releasing now. And that woman was, after few years, she doing silence start, and she doing silence, 1 month silence, 2 months silence, 3 months silence. Like 1 month alone in room, don't want to see anyone. 3 months, don't want to see anyone. Totally silent. And then I say, look, same woman. She cannot stop the talk, and now she don't want to even talk to anyone. Because she throw out everything, she released. She was heavy, full till here, and now slowly she is gone. And she was the most silent person around these all people. As she was before, she was most talker, most talking, and then she was very silent. Often she go in silence, because somebody asking also she not talking much, because she feels no. Then I say, okay. So same thing is a psychologist also, psychological, who do. And if they patient, and he said to me 2 days before, we are very patient, wife and husband both work together. Very patient. I not learning anywhere to be psychologist. I not listening anything. I not reading so much. But just reading this should be patient. Listen. And don't know what is, just I listening, and day after they say patient say, oh, I am very good, very relieved, you are thankful, very good, thank you. And then they do next treatment, they do after something. But this is like how to do. So this karma is happening like this. And karma is create cleaning, but just you sit silent. Automatic your karma is clear, and which day your all karma is clear, mind will be dropped. Mind cannot stay. Mind is staying far because karma. Karma is the fuel, food. Otherwise he cannot stay. Karma, good karma or bad karma. Sometimes he do bad karma, sometimes good karma. Everybody. Sometimes you're doing good karma, and sometimes you're doing bad karma. Sometimes your positive energy, everything good coming. Sometimes very negative energy, everything bad. Even for same person. For same person, maybe your wife, sometimes you're very good, doing nice for her, help bringing things, doing how much I can do for you. When you negative mood, then hammering on her, shouting on her, you not doing this thing, you not should do this. Like just abusing and hammering start. But you are, how is your energy that time? But karma is creating. And everybody karma create in the world. And this karma also, if you go in market, also karma is creating. You taking anything, karma is creating. So just maybe he is making karma. Without, otherwise he cannot be also here. Even for enlightenment. If he can create karma, then he can be in body. For body needs the karma. Otherwise no meaning. Body cannot stand. Body just finish. Like a dead. Will be dead body. Cannot work. So if you ask about any master or he looks like he cheating. But maybe he making karma with them. So you have to come back again, and we have to do process, cleaning process should be, will be. But one thing only, if anybody awakened, whenever anyone awakened, looks like he is doing very bad karma or bad things or bad work, but awakening, awakened one, whatever do, it is true, it is right, even looks like very bad. Many stories has about Krishna, Shiva, they always killing the devils. One devil come, killing, he finished, then another one come, then new one come. Whole life stories like this, killing the devils. And when they killing, we say, ah, when he killed this man, means this man going to straight in freedom, straight in moksha, because Shiva killed him. But if normal man kill to each other, then okay, police and go to jail. Same, work is same. Looks like if you from here you look, he also killing. He killing with sword and other one killing with gun. But normal man when killing, karma is created. And then you have to pay back. When awakened one do, because inside in him no violence. Inside him no cheating. Inside him no any thief. Nobody is there to be cheat or thief or lie or anything like this. But just maybe some reason he can create this. But this is only one thing, one trust has to be. Keep this trust. Awakened when whatever doing, it's totally 100% right. And just 2 days, 3 days before I told also, if you look the awakened one, what he doing, how he doing, what he doing, why he doing, why, what, how, you will miss him. Sure miss. Because mind makes comparison. And mind makes, he also cheating, I am also cheating. What is difference? It means I am also awakened, no any big difference. He also making paint and giving. I'm making bank loan, taking. I'm also doing same thing. But it is big difference inside. Even master showing sometimes anger also. But inside they no have anger. Outside they showing drama, game. Because sometimes it's neat to show hard face, sometimes loving face. But inside they not loving have, not cruel have. Nothing is there. So they not affected, they not happening to each other. But from if you look from mind, you say, yeah, no any difference. This I said, if you be with master, looking him, what he doing, how he doing, why he doing, and sure you get, yeah, he doing same thing like me. Same thing, even more worse than me sometimes. Say, so I'm better. Why? This makes calculation. Mind makes calculation. And then you miss it. So always be with masters or Buddha, awakened one, to look who is he, what he is. What he doing is now. What he is. Then you always will be there. Always you enjoy with him. Otherwise mind come and mind makes you disturbed. Mind always want to make disturbed. Mind is ready, mind no have any other work. You want to get some weak point. Why he looking for others weak point? If you are weak, means I am better. Only this is reason. He want to look to others weak point or judging to others to make her himself better. I am better than you. then it's okay. A mind always is better. Better means, in this way, like when you born, existence said you in your ear, you are the special one. Very special. You are unique. Nobody like you in the world. It is true. True in this way, you are unique because you have inside divineness. You have inside consciousness. But that consciousness you not recognize and you thinking, I am the special. And then everybody showing to whole world, look, I am special, I am special. Look me, I am who I am, who I am. Whole world going like this, showing. And all this big, big thing happening to show themselves. Going in power, going in work, big, big work, going in rocket, going in moon, going in stars, be a president, be a prime minister. Just to this running like, want to show who I am. Whole world can see me, who I am. I am the president of the America, of the whole best one in the world, biggest power. Just this ego game. But he said, other line he not said, recognize what is in you speciality. He said, you are special, you are unique. But what uniqueness? This, nobody thinking it. What I have uniqueness? And then, just to forget and then showing, then thinking, I am special. Yes, I am special. Everybody think. I am the super, I am the most highest. Only last who can say, I am the last one. I am the nothing. Last way, I am last. You, everybody, go. I don't want to be even second line. I am the last line. And he is the who are, be start to be last one. He cannot be more last. He is the first one. So only awakened who understand, whose ego is finished, they say, I am the no one. I am very good to be no one. I am very good to be nothing. Because I know nothing means no any running, no any want anything, no anything want to show anything. I am okay however I am, I enjoy myself. How existence make me, I enjoy. This is Buddha out. This is egolessness. No ego, no mind. When you know mind, very simple. Osho many times said, you think who I am? He said, I am the ordinary man. Simple man, ordinary man. I enjoy myself. I enjoy my joy. Anybody come with me, okay. Not come with me, okay. I am enjoying. I am simple ordinary man. He say I am ordinary man, but he is really not an ordinary man. He is the very highest man. No one like him. Be ordinary is most difficult. Be something, very easy. Everybody want to be something. And enlightenment is this, be ordinary. Be simple. Be loose and nature. Nothing to do then. Be loose in nature. Nothing to do. For you have to be something, you have to do. But for be nothing, you need to do. And this is the most difficult things, to be nothing.
Yes.
Because existence play game with us. He say, you are the unique. In everyone ears, he say, when you born, going now, you going in the world, you are unique. You are very special. In one way, he said, very truth. You are very special. Very special because you are the consciousness. very special. You are not, don't think what you are. You are unique. You are conscious. But people not understand, don't know what they are consciousness, and then they showing start, whatever they are. I'm body, I'm mind, I'm this big, and just showing start. Power, money, this type things they showing. Look me. And then really it is not. So this karma is, but what, one thing again, whatever master is doing, don't look. Sometimes they're doing funny things, very strange things. Sometimes master doing for us, we have concepts, conditioning, master should be like this. Enlightenment means this. And master will, real master come, he will break this all condition. He said, no. Don't think, master can be, Buddha can be everything. Buddha can do everything. Buddha can be everywhere. Everything can go, everywhere can go. Even you cannot go, but he can go. He can go in hell to hell. And he can go heaven to heaven. Because he don't have any problem with go anywhere, to do anything. Because for him, no any sin, no any virtue. He's beyond this all. He no have mind. Mind has sin, mind has virtue, mind has good, mind has bad. When you go no mind, you're beyond all of this. So it's no matter. Therefore I say, 2 days before, like also break the so many conditions. Conditioning of the master, how will be enlightenment. Enlightenment should be like, we have heard, we have ideas, so many ideas has. Everybody has. Master should be like this. Master should be not talk about sex, not talk about money, not look the girls, and he break all. He said, money, I'm talking about money. Money, he said, even not talking. He said, make money as much as. Money is no problem. You can enjoy the money. Just you use your mind and body and you make money and make life your luxury and good. Finish your clean, fulfillment, your desires. If you understand, desires is not fulfillment, then maybe you're not going for money. You just go for money for need, basic needs, whatever need is. But if you have desire, say go. Go for it, do it, and look, do it, and then finally you get desire never fulfilled. When you understand desire not fulfilled, automatic you drop to get the money. Because money not giving you satisfaction. No anything giving you satisfaction. Satisfaction we have own inside. Only. Satisfaction in you. No one can make you satisfied. No anything can make you satisfied. Satisfaction only when you come back to your center. Come back to your consciousness. Come back to yourself. That is full, really satisfied. Then you have anything, okay. No have anything, also okay. What about money? Millionaires people. So much money, even they don't know how much have. And one poor man, even he don't have money for survive. Eating same. Same thing eating, same two bread,
rice is
and one sabji and one rice, little one plate. Even millionaires people more sick, doctor say don't eat this, not eat this, not eat this. Poor people more healthy, physical more healthy. They can eat anything and digest. His digestion also finished. He is not doing anything. But sleeping, when they both sleeping, after sleep they don't know, don't know where you sleep. You sleeping in 5-star, or you sleeping in just in jungle, in just in one rock. No matter, you sleeping in palace, or you sleeping in hut. After sleep you don't know. Before sleep, your psychology, I am in good room, I have luxury, I have everything, I have AC, I have this. But as you slept, after 8 hours, morning, you sometimes get up, people don't know where I am. First they looking, this is my room, this is my cupboard, this is my clothes, I'm in my home. Many times happen to be forget where they are. Because in sleep you don't know 8 hours, 6 hours, where you been, what you did. Sleep makes you one. But before sleep and after sleep, when you wake up, then mind starts. So this is just mind desire, mind psychology. To make, I'm luxury, I'm this. But luxury, okay. Luxury, no problem. You have luxury, okay. But only remember, I am not for it. These things cannot make me joy. Therefore, Master, like Osho said, okay, you do. As much as luxury you can be. Finally, in the end, you're coming in this conclusion, and no any luxury can make me satisfied. And when you're satisfied, even you in simple room, you will enjoy. When you good mood, positive mood, everything beautiful. Very simple room, very small room, one room. And this room looks like everything. Delicious. So room not giving us, or some person not giving us joy or love. Love we have. Joy we have. So all the masters say, you have already, you have to discover it. Take out it. Recognize it. And for that, no need to look anywhere. Look you. Close your eyes, close your ears. Go inside. As you go, you will find. As you go, start to deeper. First you find the love. Maybe just few drops. One drops if you get, your life is changing, start. Then you go more deeper, drops become big water. More deeper, water become like a pond. You can jump on it. All around your joy, all around your water. More deeper, pond become the lake. Very much, much joy. So all around you joy, everywhere joy. You enjoy. Your body, you are going inside. Everywhere around you joy. Like if you going in lake. You go in river, what joy is very flowing. You also flowing in joy with river. Same we have river. River of the joy. And then one day go more totally in centered. Fully centered, you will be ocean of the joy. Ocean is unlimited. Joy and joy and joy. Who are coming? They go in joy. Who coming near you? Who coming near to ocean? Will joy. Become the ocean, start, go inside. Enjoying start. So, it's like this. We have this in us. Too much joy. Unlimited joy, never end joy. But we have to recognize. Which day, as you getting joy start, automatic your outer joy will be finished. You will be not interested. You say, okay, whatever time I have, I enjoy myself. Okay, I doing things, I have to work, I have to be with, connected with some friends, some family, some people. But as I get the time for me. Because I want, and this is real joy. Real joy when you have joy and you don't know why I have joy. Without reason. This is real joy. And joy really itself without reason. When your joy starts, you just alone in your house, or sitting alone in beach, or walking alone on the street, and joy is showering. Joy is happening. You very good. My whole body enjoying, mind also enjoying. Time is going fast, you are enjoying. And then you are on the right track, right path. You getting right way. Come to right way. But people don't know we have inside joy, therefore they looking outside. As you know, start, and meditation teach you this, make you this. Meditation with one, if you are getting start the joy. And you know, oh, in meditation what happened? Sometimes in meditation, when meditation you're going is very perfect or very right, suddenly joy come. And when you have joy, you say, I not did anything, I not be with anyone, just closing eyes, and I'm very good mood, very perfect, very nice feeling, beautiful feeling. And then you know, oh, joy I have me. In me, nowhere. One master was Kabira, he say in Hindi, Kasturi kundal base mragdune banmai. He say one animal, this deer, he has kasturi. I don't know what is in English, this smell coming. Yeah, in his stomach. Sometime in him, this smell come. And when this smell come to deer, he go crazy. He just running start, maybe from here. Even he hit himself, hit to trees, hit to anything. Then he running here, then he running here. Where from this smell coming? Because this smell makes him very joyful and crazy. And he looking where. He go there, all around running. And Kabira said, don't run. It is in you. So same he say, as this deer become crazy, we also become crazy. Sometimes this smell comes, and we think, oh, I have woman, therefore smell coming. She giving me joy. I have man, he giving me joy. I have power giving me joy. I have this, therefore joy. But after some time, your illusion is broken. Oh no, this woman never can give me joy. Same woman, beginning giving very joy, after 6 months, oh, this woman, no, I want to finish. I want to, don't want to look her whole life. Happened this? What happened? Because joy in you, and here you not looking, you thinking is there. Because our eyes outside, listening outside. And master say, listen inside, looking inside, there is joy, is there. Your energy, your source, as energy is coming, this energy is joyful. When you go energy and watching energy, connected with your inner energy, you feel joy start. So joy in you, nowhere else. Which day you know? Then you're not looking joy for outside. Then will be different. You will be joyful with you. Only you be with others or be with anyone to share your joy. You are full, very over full, and then what to do? Very heavy, very full of joy. Okay, go, this joy go somewhere. Then I will be light, like cloud. Cloud when we full of water, they looking where is earth, is dry earth, want to run, want to rain. And become like full of joy, full of energy. And this energy, when you are full, then okay. Therefore, Master says, sharing is the must. Whatever joy you get, whatever beauty you get, how much love you get, share. When you sharing, then this love become more. New love coming. Because now you know the source. Source you know. Here you give and new come. Slowly one day you will be, like if you seen any masters, any Bhagwan, any God pictures, sometimes they have one hand here and one hand here. From here energy coming and here energy going towards. They are medium. And you become the medium. New, fresh, all the time energy come. Newly and fresh and going in. This hand give and this hand coming. You are the medium. Wow. Then your life will be thankful. Why you came here? Aim is done. Which day you become the medium of the existence? You no more existence, whatever want to do, do. Existence flow through you. Where you look is beauty. Where you listen is divine. What you say is divine. Everywhere just beauty and divine. Then life is perfect. For whatever you came here, it is get. And we came here for it. Till you not be like this, don't stop. Don't think you have anything. When you become medium of existence, then you understand it is perfect. Why, for what I came here, it is happy. Existence choose me. Existence take me, become, make me medium doing his work. And then you will be very satisfied also. You satisfied? Very perfect. Very joyful. Yes. For whatever I came, it is happy. Giving this joy, love, sharing. Sharing with nature, sharing with people, sharing with the whole, whatever. This makes you very satisfied. You are very fulfillment. When you leave the body, you say, yes, I am very full. I am full with joy and this joy also going everywhere. Like no need anything. So love is the main. Be love and share the love. Make you love, make inside love, be full of love, and then sharing. Sharing will happen anyhow. When you will be full, this love want to go. Then you are say, I want to finish, I want to go. This go, too much you teach. When you not have love, then you say, give me love, give me love, give me love. Everybody saying to each other, give me love. And love is not say, give me. Love is make inside and give to others. Then this world will be more beautiful, more joyful, more humble, more one. Okay, so we finish now. And yesterday we have retreat and today is still going on, meditation retreat. And after satsang will be one meditation, dance type meditation, active dance, 1 hour meditation will be. And then after lunch, who doing retreat, they come here and we have sessions. It is emotions. Cleaning retreat. Emotion has to be clean. Your anger has to be clean. your possessiveness, your attachment, your greed, your jealousy should be clear, has to go out. As go out, this all change, transform in love and beauty and joy. For love and beauty, no need to get. Just clean your emotion, clean your darkness, and this darkness become light. And love and beauty is light. And you have light. You have beauty. Okay. Put music now. Mantra. We enjoy the mantra.